what IGNOU is doing in specific. May I request?
We all know, and it is going to be implemented very shortly. The importance of the subject and everything is known. I would like to introduce that those who are in touch with the subject. Recently there was a news that in Sydney a lot of fruit and vegetables were contaminated with the herbicides and pesticides. Similarly, there was a news particularly about the something that the quality of the pulses which was given to the Honorable Prime Minister at the IIT Kanpur was not of the good quality. So I will request that you be in touch with the subject on the current topics. To deal with this topic on Food Laws and Standards Act, we have Shri K.M. Nath, who is the Joint Director in Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. He is a MSc Food Technologist from CFTRI and has more than 30 years of experience. He has worked 4 years in the industry, then 25 years in a different capacities, from the inspecting officer to the joint director at the Ministry of Food Processing Industries, and for last 2 years he is with the Food Safety and Standard Authority of India. He is also the in charge for the implementation of the CRA MMPO, that is Central Registry Authority MMPO, which is with the Food Safety and Standard Authority of India. I request Dr. Nath to give the salient features about this act.
Friends, all of you are aware about various regulations related to food, like Prevention of Food Adulteration Act and various order like MFPO, FPO, this food product order, milk product order, and edible oil product order under Essential Commodity Act. Basically, this act and standards speaks about quality and standards of the product, but here is an act which is called Food Safety and Standards Act 2006, which not only gives importance of quality and standards, but give priority to the safety of food, because safety is an vital important to the consumer as well as to the food business operator. Food safety means an assurance that food is acceptable human consumption, and the consumer who eat the food does not do any harm to them, and the food is not adulterated. So food safety is not only important to the consumer, but also important to the person who deal with production, processing, distribution and sale of various food products. Friends, as I already mentioned that there are various act and regulations related to food, like Prevention of Food Adulteration Act and various orders like MFPO, FPO, meat food product order, then edible order. There are 7 to 8 standards and order which deals with the food products, and there are 7 to 8 department who regulate these standards and regulations and rules. So to consolidate this act and regulations, Food Safety and Standard Act 2006 was promulgated by the Parliament on 5th of September, on 24th of August 2006. Under this act, Food Safety and Standard Authority has been established on 5th of August, September 2008. The basic purpose and objectives of the authority is to lay down science-based standards for articles of food, regulate manufacture, storage, distribution and sale of article of food, so that food is distributed and consumed by the consumer is of wholesome and which is fit for human consumption. As I already mentioned, the existing rules like PFA, FPO deal with food products and MFPO meat products and edible oil products order. All these orders and PFA Act will be repealed once this Food Safety and Standard Act is implemented, which is going to be implemented very soon. Already there is a transition from PFA to FSSA Act, and this has been also drafts, rules and regulation has been put on the website, and it is in the final stage for implementation. After notification of these regulations, it will be implemented with maybe within 2-3 months. There is some deviation from the existing act, that is PFA Act. For the food in under the PFA, this Food Safety Standard Act means any substance, whether processed, partially processed or unprocessed, which is intended for human consumption and includes primary food. This is very important. Primary food, and also include genetically modified food, organic foods, and also alcohol, which was not covered so far under Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, and also water used for manufacturing and processing of food included under this act. Here, primary food means an article of food being produced of agriculture, horticulture, or animal husbandry, and drying or aquaculture is of natural form resulting from growing, raising, cultivation, picking, harvesting, collection or catching in the hands of person other than farmer or fisherman. This is very important. That means other than a farmer or fisherman, the food is in the hands of anybody, in the middleman, on the transit or in the processing stage or in the distribution, marketing and selling stage, it will be covered under this act. There are some salient features of the act which are as follows. It shifts from multi-level control to single line of control. As I already mentioned, there are 7 to 8 regulations which control the food and food products. So under this act, everything will be controlled by Food Safety and Standard Authority of India. So there is a single line of control, and that it ensures that the food meets consumer expectation in terms of nature, substance and quality, and is not misleading in any manner. Next is the role of food inspector. So far the food inspector, people think that is Inspector Raj. So under this act, the role of food inspector is redefined, and they are designated as food safety officer with better qualification, with proper qualification or science graduate or even food technology background. Then some new products, well, I have mentioned that GM food, dietary supplements and nutraceuticals are also brought under the purview of this act. Another important feature of the act is the small business operators are exempt from licensing. At present under PFA Act, everything from small to big, if manufacturing or distribution, they have to obtain license from PFA, from the state government. But under this act, the small business operator are exempted from the licensing. However, they will be required to register under local authority. Another important feature is the regulation of imported food in the country. So far, the imported food is not properly regulated under PFA Act because of some lack of infrastructure. Now, in the present act, the imported food will be properly regulated once it arrives in the port, or before arrival, pre-arrival some steps are being taken, and post-arrival during samples, sending to laboratory, and result within 5 days of sending to laboratory. These are the new provisions are being made for regulation of imported product. Then there is a provision of surveillance, traceability and food recall. At present there is not much effective system in place for recall of the product. If anything, any product there is found to be not fit for human consumption, or there is a instance of food poisoning or anything goes wrong in the food product, these are not recalled or taken back by the manufacturer or distributor immediately. So the new proposition in this act, the proper system is being made so that anything goes wrong and the food product, if the food product, any article of food will be taken back with proper surveillance and traceability management system. Then there is another drawback in the present system, that there is a lack of laboratories in the country. There are only 4 laboratories, national level laboratory, central laboratory, and about 70 laboratories in state level. These are found to be very much inadequate. To take care of this, the large number of network and laboratory in the state and central level is being set up or recognized. Even private laboratories are being recognized. At present, there is a proposal of recognition about 300 laboratories accredited, recognition by QCI or other organizations for analysis of samples. And then there is another provision in this act that a purchaser may have get the sample analyzed. They can collect the sample from the shop and send to the food analyst for analysis, and if anything goes wrong, that manufacturer or trader may be prosecuted or penalized. But this provision may be misused, so there is safeguard that once the purchaser draw the samples, he has to inform the designated officer, and this may be done in front of the designated officers. So these are the safeguard provision is made. Another provision, that the panchayat and local bodies are involved in food safety plans. I already mentioned that small business, petty food business operator may be exempted from licensing. So this business operator will be required to register under panchayat, local panchayat and municipal level. And there is a food safety plan. The panchayat level presidents or secretary and other members are being involved for this food safety plan. Then there is a very important provision in this act, that graded penalty and punishment. In the present act, for any offense, whether it is minor or major, if a product is adulterated or substandard, the offense is the prosecution. At least if it is found guilty, it is 6 months of imprisonment. But in the present act, if it is a very small or minor offense, then there will be penalty, may say about 1 lakh, or it varies from 1 lakh to 5 lakh of rupees. Then there is a new justice dispensation system for fast track disposal of cases. At present, the cases for any adulteration and prosecution takes years of time to be disposed. To dispose these cases very quickly, the fast track courts are being set up in a district level, so that cases are disposed of very quickly, particularly the cases involving the grievous injuries and death due to consumption of food. Then finally, there is a harmonization of domestic and standard with international standards. At present, there are variants in our domestic standards, like PFS standards or FPO standards or milk food product standard, with the international standards like CODA standards or Euro standard. So this authority is being taken care of, that these standards are being harmonized with our domestic standards. Then establishment of administrative setup. As I already mentioned, the food safety standard authority has been set up in 2008, headed by a chairperson who is not the below the rank of secretary to the Government of India. And there are 22 members in the authority. Among them, 7 are of government ex officio member, which are not the below the rank of Joint Secretary to the Government of India, and there are 15 other members from different sector, from in small scale industries, consumer and farmers organization, eminent food technologist, and one each from each zone in the specified in this scene. There are 5 zones specified in this act, so one representative from each zone is selected in the authority. This is the constitutional authority. Then there is in the authority there is a central advisory committee to advise the authority in the various matter related to safety of foods. Chief executive officer is the appointed the central who is the legal representative of the food authority and is the ex officio chairperson of the central advisory committee. In this committee there are members from food industry, agriculture, consumer organization, relevant research bodies, food laboratories, and small food safety and state food safety commissioners. And chairperson of the scientific committee, there are 8 scientific committee. So each chairperson of the scientific committee is the member of central advisory committee. There is a scientific committee for providing advice to the authority in scientific matter. It consists of chairperson of scientific panels and 6 independent scientific experts not belonging to or affiliated to any other scientific panels. It provides opinion in multi-sectoral issues falling within the competence of more than one scientific panel, and issues which do not fall within the competence of scientific panels. As I already mentioned, there are 8 scientific panels of different field, like scientific panel of additives, flavoring, processing aids and materials in contact with food, scientific panel on pesticides and antibiotic residues, genetically modified organisms and food, functional food, nutraceutical and similar products, panel on biological hazards, contaminant and food chain, and then labeling and method of sampling and analysis. The scientific panel may invite the relevant industry and consumer representative during their deliberations for their opinion and advice and guidance. Then this is the structure of food authority. It is at the central level food safety standard authority, headed by chief executive officer, and the headquarters in Delhi. Then chief scientific officer, chief surveillance officer, and there will be a zonal. Already I mentioned that there are 5 zones. There will be zonal directors for issuing license and implementation of the act. And in the state level, there will be a food safety commissioner, and below him there is a designation officer who for day-to-day functioning, issuing license, and then there is a food safety officer who are basically a field officer for inspection, drawing of sample, and to ensure maintenance of hygienic and sanitary conditions in the food business establishment. And then there will be laboratory headed by joint director or chief food analyst and food analyst. These are the implementing structure of the authority. Then there will be education and food safety tribunals. As I already mentioned, that for any offenses there may be a penalty or punishment for any offense. So there will be to decide that penalty, quantum of penalty, there will be an executing officer who will be not below the rank of an additional district magistrate. There will be one executing officer at least in a district or a zone. And then there will be food safety appellate tribunal. Central government or state government may notify and establish one or more tribunals known as food safety appellate tribunal. If there is an appeal for any decision by the executing officer, So they can approach to the appellant authority. And then there will be special courts, as I already mentioned, for quick disposal of cases, the matter related to grievous offenses due to food poisoning or death or serious injury. These cases will be decided within a time limit of say 3 years. Or there will be a provision for immediate relief for the victims for serious injuries or death. So there will be a provision for fast takers, special courts for deciding these cases. The role of food safety standard authority as per the act. The basic functions of the food safety standard authority of India will be framing rules, regulations, standards and guidelines in relation to articles of food, guidelines for accreditation of certification of bodies and laboratories. This, as I already mentioned, that FSSI will be recognizing and at least laboratories in the country. So main functions and responsibility of FSSI to do set up the laboratories or recognize the laboratories for analysis of samples, for quality control and maintenance and ensuring of standards of the product. Then notification of testing lab, including private laboratories. As I already mentioned, that private laboratories also may be accredited or recognized for analysis of sample. And then scientific advice and support to the central government and state government, state food safety commissioner. Those are already in implementing of this act. So basic functions of the food safety and standard authority is to provide the support guidelines and also to collect and collate the data on food consumption, incidents of food poisoning, and then risk analysis, risk management, and introduction of rapid alert system. If anything goes wrong, that should be immediately informed to the industry, or that system should be in place so that industry or food business operator may immediately inform the incidents of any food poisoning and other problem related to food to the designated officers who is the responsible for regulation of the act. Now, even that central food standard authority role is capacity building from various stakeholders. The state government is not fully equipped at present to implement the act. So the central authority is trying to build the capacity of the state government. Presently we are conducting many workshop and even training program to educate the food inspector. Those are already under FS Prevention of Food Adulteration Act inspector. So they will be designated food safety officer until the new officers are appointed, and they will be properly trained how to implement the act, because their present role is not only to inspect, collect sample and prosecute, but their role is also to be a guide and advise the food business operator for the improvement and to maintain the quality of their products, and promote general awareness among the food safety officer and also food business operators and consumers about the importance of the quality and food safety of the products. And also prepare guidelines for risk analysis, methodologies and safety plans for food business operators. Then role of state government as per the act. In the state government level, I have already mentioned that there will be a food safety commissioner who will be state level officer. He is the main responsibility to ensure efficient and uniform implementation of the standards and other requirements of food safety. Carry out survey and inspection of food processing units in the state to find out compliance of prescribed standards. An organized training program for the personnel engaged in the implementation of food safety regulations. Prohibit in the interest of consumer, if anything goes wrong, to manufacture and sale of food and food products. then sanction prosecution for offences punishable under the rule with the imprisonment or penalty. So he is the sanctioning of authority if any prosecution or is to be launched against any food business operator. Then role of designated officer. I already mentioned that below the food safety commissioner there will be a designated officer, maybe in the district level or zonal level. His main function is to issue a license to the food business operator, whether it is a manufacturing unit or a distribution unit or anybody in the hotel or restaurant business, or any storage of distribution warehouse, anything dealing with food business, he will be responsible to issue license and also issue improvement notice to take appropriate measures for rectification of the product or improvement of the product, and maintenance of record all of inspection made by the food safety officer for follow-up action. He can also prohibit manufacture and sale if that is a contravention of the regulations. Make recommendation to the commissioner of food safety for sanction of launching prosecution. So food safety commissioner, as I mentioned, can sanction the prosecution for any offense, but it will be done only after recommendation of the designated officer. The designation of the officer will be not below the rank of subdivisional magistrate. And then this designation officer will receive reports of the samples collected and analyzed by the food analyst, and if anything goes wrong, he will take proper action, including suspension or cancellation of license granted and recommending prosecution for the offense to the commissioner. And then if anything it's done wrong or any complaint against the food safety officer, because these provisions of this act, if the food safety officer is also found to be in fault or anything he does mischievous, his activity is not with at par with his duty or responsibility, he may be also prosecuted for contravention or his misconduct. So designated officer can recommend his disciplinary action against the food safety officer, including punishment. Under this law, a food safety officer also may be penalized up to ₹1 lakh if he is found to be guilty of taking any wrong action. Then role of and responsibility of food safety officer. Next, implementing personnel is the food safety officer. He is basically a field officer going to food business establishment, whether it is manufacturing or hotel or any distribution place. He will inspect to ensure the compliance of hygiene and sanitary conditions laid down in the regulations, and he will collect sample, send to laboratory and get it analyzed. And he can also seize an article of food if on the spot it is found to be contravening any order and it is found to be not as per quality standard. So he can seize or detain the product and issue a seizure memo to the food business operator. He may give after giving notice cause unsafe food product destroyed. If it found anything where a product is not suitable or fit for consumption, prima facie, so he can get the product destroyed also. And he can already mentioned that he can also be penalized for harassment of food business operator or taking any rock if it is proved that he has taken action who is not as per the provision, so he may also be penalized. So role of and responsibility of food business this food safety officer is very important, because he is the actual person who is doing the action and implementing the act in the field. there is an implementation stage. I mentioned that there is a licensing and registration as per section 31 of this act. Any food business operator has to take license from the appropriate authority, whether it is central or state government, except the petty food business operator. This petty food business operator may be very small vendor or retailer. So in our new licensing registration regulation, we are keeping some limit, say below 200 kg or 500 kg in case of milk and milk product. Who is dealing below 500 kg will not be required to obtain license. Or in other product it may be 100 kg. Or in case of retail business or wholesale business, if annual turnover is not more than 12 lakhs, so he will be required to register under the local authority like panchayat level or local municipal level. And above that, one is to obtain license. So licensing also, there are two-tier licensing. One is in the state level and another in the central level. This is the actually this licensing and registration is three-tier. One is registration under local authority, maybe panchayat or in the municipal level. That registration authority will be notified by state food safety commissioner. And there are state licensing authority. This designated officer will be state licensing authority, who will not be below the rank of sub-judicial magistrate. And there is a central licensing authority, maybe in the zonal level, the director, regional director will be licensing authority. The certain level, it is proposed that more than 2,000 kg or 2 metric ton per day install capacity of any unit, manufacturing unit, will be registered, will be licensed under central government. Or the unit having the business in more than two states, the multi-state business operation. And all important food product will be licensed under central government. So these are the three-tier registration and licensing system. Then already I mentioned that the central licensing state government is the state commissioner, registration authority, and then state licensing authority, and central level FSSI headquarters and general directors may be licensing authority. The procedure for registration and licensing. For registration, I already mentioned that it is the local authority, maybe panchayat or municipal level. So a food business operator just fill up an application, a prescribed application is there, along with a fees of 100 rupees, and he will submit to the local authority. And his application will be processed within 7 days of receipt of the application. And within 30 days, he will be issued registration. If inspection is required, within 30 days, inspection is to be done. And if he is not issued a registration certificate within 30 days, he can start his own business. This is a very important provision and power given to the food business operator, any business, manufacturing or even a retail shop. Because at present, there is an experience that it takes months together to have a registration certificate from the authority. So there is a provision that if he is not granted a registration within 30 days, he can start his own business, as if that is presumed that he has been issued registration. But subsequently, if it is found after 30 days that his business establishment is not fulfilling the requirement of standard hygienic and other standards compliance, then he will be given improvement notice. And if he is not improved within specified time, then his registration may be, means his business may be suspended and action may be taken. Then licensing procedure, if it is certain limit, I have already mentioned that maybe 100 kg or 500 kg, depending upon the type of product. We have already proposed, one can see in our website, the licensing and registration guideline is there. So one has to apply in the application, we call an application form B, along with prescribed fees also. There is a different type fees for different type of industry. So you have to submit the application to the licensing authority. If it is state licensing, then you have to apply to the designated officer. Application will be processed within 30 days if inspection is required. If it is, inspection is not required, he will be granted license within 60 days. If within 60 days or 2 months is not issued license, he may start his own business. Similarly, so all this licensing and registration authority system will be monitored through internet online. One can submit the application online, and it will be connected to the state and central level and our FSA headquarters. These are the progress in implementation of the Food Safety and Standard Act made by food our authority. Structure of the authority finalized. Some critical studies we have made, including diet survey, upgradation of testing laboratories, and imported food safety plan prepared, and finalization upgradation of referral laboratories, preparation of food safety surveillance and recall mechanism, and some product like trans fats, quality of water, and also meat and meat products. And we have also made some making some guidelines for even midday meal and capacity development food safety regulators. And finally, I have already mentioned the rapid alert system. If anything goes wrong in any stage of distribution and supply chain of food product, the immediate alert should be given to the food business operator and food safety regulator for corrective step. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nath, for a very comprehensively covering. Thank you very much.